Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. A couple of days ago, SpaceX successfully launched their 26th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 644.
2, 1, ignition, liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B1062, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This coming week we can hopefully expect a few missions to launch. The first of these, the Starlink 716 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 19th at 2:20 AM UTC or tomorrow Monday 18th at 10:20 PM EST. Then, a little later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see another Dragon mission launch. The CRS-30 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 21st at 8:55 PM UTC or 4:55 PM EST. Then, just hours after that, we could see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 642 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 22nd at 12:20 AM UTC or Thursday 21st at 8:20 PM EST. On Thursday, which was also their 22nd birthday, SpaceX launched their third Starship mission, and what a heck of a mission it was. It lifted off flawlessly from Starbase. It then successfully completed hot staging where the booster began its boost back burn and Starship headed to space. Booster 10 completed its boost back burn, but it looks like some engine issues caused it to fail and it lost control then suffered a rudd. Starship proceeded to fly successfully to space and coasted as they planned to do some tests. SpaceX then performed a test where they opened the PES door on Ship 28. Another test that SpaceX performed successfully was a propellant transfer demo between main and header tanks. Then, in one of the most spectacular videos I've ever seen, Starship began re-entering Earth's atmosphere live. Unfortunately, it seems to have been in a spin prior to and during re-entry, eventually leading to its demise. However, thanks to Starlink, we got to see unprecedented footage of the plasma engulfing Starship.
Right now, it is not. The Starlinks are still...
brought to you by Starlink.
Yeah, the Starlinks are still communicating and still capturing the data and the video that we see here. I mean, Shiva, this is just absolutely incredible views. We've never seen anything like this before. This is the biggest flying object ever in space.
Absolutely, Kate. And it's important to note, with the ascent burn that we did was to get us to orbital velocities, even though we were on a nearly orbital trajectory. So the heating and the loads that Starship is going through right now are what it would be getting if it were recovering from an orbital mission. And just the fact that we have views through entry, this is incredible.
Yeah. Again, this is the furthest and fastest that Starship has ever flown. And you can definitely tell by the crowd here in Hawthorne.
The heat shield tiles doing their work. We talked about it earlier. Up to 2600 degrees Fahrenheit that those heat shield tiles are dissipating as we...
In relation to this footage, SpaceX posted information about the capabilities of Starlink. They said reliable high-speed, low-latency internet around the world even while traveling at 27,000 kilometers per hour through a plasma field. SpaceX posted these really cool pictures of Starship's third launch. They said Starship launching for the third time from the gateway to Mars. They also posted this cool video from the top of the launch tower. Some more cool footage they posted is this slow motion video of Starship launching. On their website, SpaceX posted some information about the results of Starship's third flight. One of the things they said was Super Heavy successfully lit several engines for its first ever landing burn before the vehicle experienced a RUD. Something else they said was Starship did not attempt its planned on-orbit relight of a single Raptor engine due to vehicle roll rates during coast. Over in Starbase now, here's some footage of the orbital launch pad after the IFT-3 launch. Here's a look at the Launch Tower 2 sections progressing at Starbase. Also, here's a look at Star Factory with the expansion work continuing. There was this really cool picture of how Starship has progressed from where it started to where it is now. It says the evolution here is insane. SpaceX is one of the most innovative companies on the planet. Musk posted some information about what SpaceX expects the capacity of future Starships to be. He said max payload of Starship V1 in expendable mode like the other rockets is approximately 200 tons. V3 is expected to be around 200 tons with full reusability and around 400 tons expendable. Length will grow by 20 to 30 meters and thrust to around 10,000 tons. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.